Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome back to the Qalam Hangout. Alhamdulillah, it's been, actually we skipped a week for the Qalam Hangout, but we've been traveling. That's why we're coming to you here live on location in London. As you can see behind us, there's Big Ben and Big Murphy. So alhamdulillah, while we're on the road, we won't be able to do a live Q&A session, but we figured we'd give you a special treat and include Brother Murphy in the Hangout. So you can still send in your questions, inshallah, when I get back to the States, probably another week or so. Then we'll do a special live Q&A session. We'll catch up on your questions. So once we came here and started going around and seeing the community, a very old issue, one that's constantly talked about in our communities, came right back to the forefront. That was how we manage and how we handle sisters in our communities. We started visiting a lot of the masajid, a lot of the communities, and a phrase in English really came to mind, and that was out of sight, out of mind. They weren't there, we didn't see them, and therefore it was hard to even remember the fact that they might be listening, or they might also be addressed or be participating at any level. Brother Murphy, I mean, we were just something we've been talking about for a couple of days now.
Yeah, it's been something that we've noticed. I mean, you see, when you go to like East London, for example, you see like a ton of Muslim sisters walking around, all different kinds of, you know, cultures and backgrounds. But then when it came to the lectures that we were giving at the certain mosques and masajid, we found that sometimes the sisters weren't included in the main area, in the main hall. And the main hall was definitely large enough to comfortably seat both genders in a modest manner. And so it's coming from a background where I have three sisters of my own. Obviously, my mom is very important to me, as with everybody. And I have, you know, a wife, alhamdulillah. And I have a sister-in-law who I'm very close to, Tahseen. And then, you know, Shaykh Abdul Nasir, you know, all of you know about his Maryam and his Aisha, his two beautiful daughters, his wife, his sister, his mom. We come from a background that personally, you know, kind of almost makes us or forces us in a good way, in a way that we like, to be very cognizant of how we treat sisters and how we treat the women of our community. And making sure that they have an equal opportunity to benefit and learn from all kinds of community events so that they can better their relationship with their creator, with our creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So as a conclusion, and again, I've said this a number of times, I don't even feel the need to give the disclaimer anymore. This is the Qalam Hangout. This is where I don't have to worry about stepping on anyone's toes. So I'm just going to say at least what my personal analysis of the issue is. When you read the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, you read about the community of Rasulullah ﷺ, how the Prophet ﷺ taught discipline to both genders in terms of interacting and managing their interaction with one another. What I feel, you know, we're human beings. We're never going to be angels. We're never going to be perfect in terms of gender interaction. But both genders need to take responsibility. What the way it's going right now in our communities, we are making one of the genders bear the burden of the irresponsibility of the other gender.
And to be clear, it's the women who are bearing the responsibility of the irresponsible men.
Absolutely. And so I just feel that based on an analysis of the community and the life of Rasulullah ﷺ, I don't feel that this is the appropriate way for us to manage the issue. We need more education, more discipline, more responsibility, but what we don't need is to shut them away in a separate area where they don't have any access to anything at all, and they're listening to a very bad quality sound system delivering the lecture from a completely different side of the area or the building. I don't feel that's going to solve the issue. And if somebody's got a more conservative position on the issue, where men should educate men, sisters should educate sisters, well, we still got to properly prepare and educate and train sisters to be in a position where they can educate our other sisters. And that's something, again, that at Qalam, that's something we haven't shied away from. We have the Khatib workshop, we have the sisters public speaking workshop, where we have the full-time Islamic studies program starting that will have room for both brothers and for sisters at the program, inshallah. So
yeah, it's just something that's really important, and I think that the more that we push away from it, the more that we're going to be basically filling up this pressure cooker of problems, and then one day it's just going to blow open on us. You know, we're going to have these different kind of issues. Basically, it's an infection that's growing.
And then all of a sudden, it's like, oh my God, where did this come from? How did this happen?
Yeah, and then
we know exactly how it happened.
We know exactly where it happened. So we really have to take care of this from the beginning. And we can't get on the member and in front of other communities and say that we treat women equally in our religion, and then turn around and not treat them equally. It's ridiculous, and it's actually a lie against the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and against ourselves. And people can smell it from a mile away. People can call it from a mile away that it's not true, and that all that we preach, unfortunately, and there are exceptions to the rule. You know, you're going to have the comments saying, oh, we do this, it's fine. In Knoxville, for example, we're renovating the sister side of the masjid, but the rule, unfortunately, not the exception, is that women are not treated equally. And so you know, just make sure, inshallah, that we treat them just how we'd want them to be treated. And part of it, Shaykh, I don't mean to cut off your conclusion, is to not see women as an opportunity. Not every woman...
PR stunt.
Yeah, and also a personal opportunity. Like, every woman you see, or man you see, for example, women, you grade them on a level, and if they're reached, you know, above an 8 or a 9, then you think about them for a rishta or for marriage. Like, women and men are brothers and sisters. See them as such. Don't see them as opportunities for intimacy or for, you know, satiating your desires. And the more that we are able to see them more as brothers and sisters, as a community, the more that we'll treat each other equally, inshallah.
Absolutely. So remember, again, if you want to check out the other videos, go to qalamhangout.com. If you want to start sending in questions to be answered in the next live Q&A session, you can leave them in the comments under this video. You can email them to us at questions@qalaminstitute.org. Or you can also Facebook message them or tweet them to us. Just remember to tag all your questions with #QalamHangout. Until next time, Jazakumullah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Peace out, Girl Scout.